So all of a sudden,
yeah,
farming communities, cities, towns, if we can do it without a lot of one-on-one contact and we can do it over social media, I'll tell you, it's more cost effective and it does get the word out in a hurry. That's for sure. Hi, this is Brian Eisenhower, and I'm here to talk to you a little bit about real estate farming ideas for an entire city. It's kind of interesting. I think these are going to be great farming ideas for just about anyone in real estate. And I've got two of the best in the business here with me, Mark and Amber Olson. Welcome, guys. Thanks for being here with us.
Welcome. Thank you for having us.
Yeah, this is awesome. Mark and Amber, they have been ICC coaching clients for several years. They're in Nevada, Iowa. Last year, they sold 161 homes. And they're the number one team in their multiple listing service, city, county, you name it. And a lot of that's because of how much they do for the community. And I think that's what a good real estate farmer does, is they add value and they come from contribution. And you guys got a kind of a unique, put in a unique situation this year where you were kind of forced to be leaders in your community because of the coronavirus, COVID-19 pandemic. Well, let's back up a second. You started out, Mark, I know you were talking about this. You started out 2020, even doing much better numbers and higher amounts of production than you had the previous year, hadn't you?
Yeah, no, that's correct. So 2019 was by far the best year we've ever experienced. And so far 2020 was off to a great start. We were, you know, if we ended April today, we would be ahead of where we were in 2019. Year to date, even with everything going on now, currently we're still putting, you know, quite a few deals together, but it's been a great start to the year real estate wise.
Right. And then comes, you know, the coronavirus, and all of a sudden, you know, we're much more limited on what we can do. And then, you know, obviously home buyers and sellers are a lot less active. You know, everyone's a lot less active. Everyone's lives and communities are disrupted because we're all staying in our houses, which is, let me tell you, from personal experience, that's something. You know, the whole family there all the time. I mean, I'm sure you guys.
Oh, yeah. We have little ones running around.
Oh, yeah, I know. And so everybody feels that way, right? You know, having, and I think that's where you guys really made a difference, is because a lot of people, especially in real estate at that time, they're like, well, I can only do what I can do, so I'm just going to kind of, you know, wait this thing out, see what happens, which is understandable. But then it's also a time where people can lead too. And I think that's what you guys have done, especially, I mean, you're about a true month into this thing, and the amount of things you have done for your community that are highly visible, right? That are highly visible. In just 1 month is just earth shock. I mean, it's just earth shattering. Like, it is, you guys have been extraordinarily busy. And it's, you know, when I talk to Mark, you know, Mark will be like, oh yeah, we did this too. And I'm like, what? And he just keeps saying, oh yeah, we're doing this too. And Amber's doing this. And I'm like, what are you talking about? Like, cause you're doing, you know, cause I know we share a lot of ideas, and then you guys are in our Real Estate Agent Roundtable Facebook group, so we get ideas.
Yes, that's been helpful. Thank you.
And now a lot of people are copying all your ideas because you're doing so many cool things, and they're taking them and doing them in their town.
Well, we appreciate you and, you know, having your support and you sharing the ideas and the other ideas from other realtors across the community too, because I think you take those ideas and you just kind of spin them a little bit to make them fit in your own community. So that's really been helpful.
Yeah, that, so, thank you. And that I want to be sure about, because it's not me coming up with any of the ideas. I am horrible at ideas, but
helping,
I'm really
share
good
the
at
ideas
sharing them. And you're right, because you guys have seemed to plus them. Like, you get the idea and then you make it fit for your town, and you spice it up a little bit in some really cool ways. And it's really, I mean, I'll be honest with you, I don't know that. I mean, it's definitely extremely appropriate to do right now, because quite frankly, people need it. They need to be uplifted. Mm-hmm. They need to be distracted. They need to feel like they're a part of the community.
Yes.
But really a lot of this stuff you could just do anytime. You know what I mean? These are things you can do for your community even when there isn't a pandemic.
Yeah, something that I've really been keeping in mind is that people are home right now and they are on social media. So any way that we can reach out to our community and we can reach out to those people that, you know, maybe they didn't have the time to be on social media so much as they do right now. And just, you know, our main goal was really to be a resource for them in our community. Think about ways that we can help them. And I think we really just want to put a smile on people's face too. So a lot of things that we did, we're always thinking about what can we do to help them so they don't feel so helpless during this time.
That's phenomenal.
A lot of the things that we're doing, I mean, we do a lot of this stuff throughout the year anyway. It's just a condensed version. We've done a lot more in 30-day window than we normally would. But, you know, even a month or month and a half ago when this all started happening, Brian, I remember you saying, you know, just focus on being a resource in your community. And that's what we've always done. And
yes,
that's, you know, 70% of our business on a year-to-date basis is typically from referral or our sphere of influence. And that's what we always focus on, is just taking care of our people. I mean, that's, you know, that's what we've done throughout this whole time as well.
Yeah, and yeah, mm-hmm. Phenomenal job. That's exactly it. And I think, you know, to what Amber said there too, you know, you take care of your people. And one of the ways we're doing it now is through social media. People are now, mm-hmm. I mean, everybody's on social media all of a sudden. I mean, what else are you going to do?
Yeah. Right?
Like,
yes.
I can tell you it's gotten me out of my comfort zone, because to be on this video right now is something I probably wouldn't have done 30 days ago because I absolutely hate it. So, uh-huh. as well as some of the agents in my office, you know, they don't, it's really helped. I mean, it's helped with a lot of that, you know, it's a lot easier to jump.
You have
on
your wife motivating you.
Yeah. That's right.
It's true. Yeah.
Poor Mark gets pressured from both me and Amber.
Yes.
I'm giving in finally.
But that is true. I mean, I think it is forcing us. I mean, we always knew we were going to have to get, you know, we're going to have to really embrace technology and social media people, but I don't know that we've ever done it. Now it's happening, and right. I'm not sure, like you just said, now I'm comfortable.
Yes.
I think everybody yeah. else is going to be comfortable too. I'm not sure that the public's going to go back. I think that a lot of people have gotten used to social media, and they're going to continue mm-hmm. to. So yeah. it behooves yeah. us to be there more. So a lot of these activities that we're doing are designed to be run over social media. So all of a sudden,
yeah.
farming communities, cities, towns, if we can do it without a lot of one-on-one contact, and we can do mm-hmm. it over social media, I'll tell you, it's more cost-effective yeah. and it does get the word out in a hurry, that's for sure.
Yeah, and videos have been great. We know how important it is to do videos. And like Mark said, he hasn't, you know, he's not really comfortable doing them yet. But we also know that one thing that we heard at a conference this past winter was that if you don't like the way that you look on video, if you don't like the way that you sound on video, get over it, because that's really how you look and sound.
Yeah.
And that really just has really stuck with me. And I tell my daughter that too. She doesn't, yeah. you know, she was listening to herself the other day on a video and I'm like, Aubrey, that is you. Like, you know.
Yeah, that's
so,
it.
It's really helped me get out of my comfort zone to think about that.
Yeah, that really is true. Like, if you don't like how you look, well, boy, you've gone a long time in your life being in total denial as to how you really look.
Right, yeah. We know that people like videos, and so Mark and some of our other agents have been doing a really good job trying to go out of their comfort zone and do some videos. So Mark, maybe you can talk about what you've done partnering with local general store.
Yeah. So the first thing that we did here about a month ago was when this all started coming to fruition here locally in Iowa, is we decided to partner with a local general store called Ben Franklin's. So they have, you know, some of your essentials like your toilet papers and some of your home goods that you might need. So we at that time had offered to allow anybody, if they wanted to call in, place an order for what they needed, make payment arrangements. Ben Franklin would take their address, they would contact our office, and then we would make arrangements to get the stuff delivered to their doorstep. So we had quite a few people take advantage of that and getting everything, you know, dropped off at their house or at their doorstep. So it allowed, you know, the elderly and whatnot who didn't want to venture out to still get what they needed.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's excellent. Yeah. So you, general store, and this is where you're starting to weave in, like you're shooting the video around it, you're promoting it, like they're seeing you. You know what I mean? It's not just images, you're not hiding behind things. You're shooting videos, you're getting out in front of it. And that's what I think social media is them connecting with you. So you're getting out leading, almost like you're face-to-face through a video. And it's almost like you're there in their, you know, on their doorstep or in the office or in the grocery store, so.
Yeah, and you had the employees help. They were in on the video too.
Right, yeah, that's excellent.
And I think that's really important to see it put a face to who works at these establishments in our community as well, because they might then see them at, you know, the local grocery store and recognize these people. And maybe they'd be more willing to go visit, you know, the local store then.
Sure. I mean, and now, you know, you've promoted this local store, made them look good. So there's a connection between you guys and them there. So you're helping local business. And every local business has a following. You know, there's people that just like, so now you've ingratiated yourself with them too. Those people that are big fans of the Ben Franklin General Store are now big fans of your real estate team. You know what I'm saying? So you're extending that circle of people by involving more people, helping more people, bringing a community tighter at a time when, you know, it's hard to do that, you know, which is.
Yeah.
Which is
so we were trying to reach the grocery stores, the general store, people like that. And then we thought, we had another idea to work with the restaurants then, to kind of focus on getting people still in to, you know, at least do carry out during this time. Our carry out services are still available.
Ongoing too, but every week, Thursday, we announce the business that's going to be in the running for our $19 giveaway. So every Thursday, it's the $19 COVID-19 giveaway. So we give away a $19 gift card to support a local business. Typically right now we're focusing on restaurants, but you know, every week we do this, and individuals just have to like our page, comment on what they enjoy the most about that place of business to be entered into the drawing. And it's been fun. You know, we get a ton of response out of it. It's been cool to see all the comments that people make. Every Thursday we have our team meeting. One of the agents will announce the winner and what business will be moving forward for the next week.
Yeah, something really personal, I feel like, is people will comment not only with their favorite, you know, food at that restaurant, but they'll also comment on how they love the service and love the owners and everyone's so friendly. And then we also get comments about personal experiences that people have had, that, you know, this one girl remembered going there with her dad, who has now recently passed away. And that was a special memory that she shared with him there. So, you know, we get some heartwarming stories too. People are opening up.
Yeah, I love it. I mean, you're giving $19. I love it how it ties in with COVID-19.
Yeah.
I mean, even if it were $20 during a normal time, I mean, that's $20 a week. That's an $80 investment a month. That's not, if you know, if there's 4 weeks in a month, that's not breaking anyone's bank. Yet you're promoting all these different businesses. You're gaining traction. You're getting all this positivity. It's really engaging. It's much more powerful than much cheaper and more powerful than a mailer. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Once COVID-19's gone, I don't see this going away. I mean, we've had a lot of good response out of this. It's kind of fun to do. Everyone gets to interact with it. So I see us continuing this for a long time.
Yeah.
Yeah. What I was going to say is, going off of cheap and free, we've also been doing, and mostly focusing on our family and friends, but if people reach out to us and need help, then we help them. But we've been doing, since, you know, because of social distancing, we have kids, adults unable to celebrate their birthdays. And so we've been doing a birthday parade. And we started doing this for my friend who turned 40. And we all met at a certain place and got together and started a train and went by her house and whatnot. And so now actually the fire department has gotten involved. And so they are actually sending their fire engines out, and you can call ahead of time within, you know, before the birthday, and set up a time that the fire engines will come over and drive past your house. And they'll, you know, light up their lights and do the sirens, and then we create the parade behind them then. So they've been doing that just for the kids. And then the adults, we just kind of arrange it ourselves. But that's something fun. And we also put up a sign that says, honk, you know, it's my birthday today. So that way, you know, just putting a smile on people's face that they aren't able to celebrate their birthdays in a large gathering right now. So
that's really cool. We're talking about supporting businesses, supporting children, supporting people in need with the grocery. And all through basically through social media. I mean, we can do some of this, and you do, through email and whatnot, existing database. But I think it's really visual on social media. It really is.
Yeah.
I think some of the most ridiculous results, Amber, you were telling me about were was the egg hunt. Tell me about that, the Easter egg.
Yes. Well, there is a bear hunt that was huge in our community. Everyone put up stuffed animal bears around the houses, and people would go on a bear hunt. So we thought, well, we got that in a spinoff from something that you had posted. Another realtor did like an egg hunt. So we went off of that. And what we did was ask the community to create a homemade Easter egg, and we provided templates if they wanted them. They could print them off. We also offered to have some at our office if they wanted to pick up, or we could drop some off. at their front porch, so there wasn't any contact. And otherwise, we just did, like, you know, I really encourage creativity, and so coming up with, you know, drawing it yourself and making it yourself. But so then everyone, if you wanted to participate, you could hang up your Easter egg, your homemade Easter egg, on the front of your house. We had these done by Saturday morning at 9 a.m., which was just Saturday, April 11th. And then families, we encouraged them, anyone in the community, whether they, you know, kids are along or grandparents or whoever, could go on a little egg hunt. And so they had all day Saturday, all day Sunday, to go on this egg hunt and count how many eggs, homemade eggs, you would find around the community. So we were getting numbers in, you know, the hundreds, which I thought was like, whoa. Well, then all of a sudden more and more started coming in, and we're getting numbers from 100 to 800 homemade eggs being found. The top winning family that found the most eggs actually found 822 homemade eggs.
Yeah, I was thinking like 40 boys. 40's a winner.
Yeah.
These eggs were huge. There was eggs that are 6 feet tall, 5 feet tall. I mean, people really got creative with it.
Yeah, people got creative. It was so fun. And just another way to just pull the community together and give something fun for the kids to do. Because I always love it when my kids have something fun, you know, to go to, or an event to go to, or something to do. So yeah, now we're just helping create those ideas.
At this point, newspapers are picking up on it, right? I mean, people are starting to, I mean, because they're seeing what you're doing. And I mean, it's a scary time, you know. We'll look back at this one of the scariest times in our lives. And, you know, the media are looking for good things to talk about. It's usually not the case, but now you got like media sources like, hey, we need something positive, right? And here you're providing that. So now you know, they're talking about it. And that wasn't even your intention. But now you're getting all this publicity about everything you're doing. Like, you're leading the business world, and you're leading, you know, all of society, actually, with regards to, you know, community involvement and togetherness.
Yeah, different ideas. Well, then we end up taking the Easter egg idea and we took the fire trucks, you know, being involved in the birthday parades, and we combined the two, and we thought, well, how about we see if we can get the Easter bunny to ride on the fire truck on Easter Day, because our Easter eggs egg hunts were all canceled for the day, of course, or for the weekend. So I knew the costume would be available, so we went to our local Nevada JC's chapter, and they had the costume for us, and they actually had a volunteer that wanted to be the Easter bunny for us. I then contacted our fire department, and they've been really, you know, we've just really started working with them on something else that we do in August. We have, Mark kind of brought back the Nevada Community Rodeo. Well, you did bring it back. So we've been getting to know the police officers, police department through that event. And so then it's just all about relationship building. And so this was another idea that I went to them and asked, would you be willing to have just one fire truck, you know, come drive around the community, and the Easter bunny can ride in it, and just a way to put a smile on everybody's face. So that's what I thought was going to happen. So we showed up with, it was Mark and I, and then our three kids, and we weren't quite sure who was going to ride in the fire truck or whatnot, how that was going to work out. But we pull up into the fire station, and all of a sudden more, like, people just keep coming and coming. And all of a sudden we have three fire engines, or three fire trucks, that are going to be following along with us, along with a cop, a Nevada cop from the police department, and about at least 10 other volunteers that just really wanted to ride in the fire truck. So what I thought was going to be just this one little, you know, parade with the Easter Bunny turned into what went from one fire engine, went to three fire engines and a cop following us. So it was really neat. And
it shows it how just, you started. And then the Nevada Journal,
4 hours later, parading around town, we were done with our parade.
Yeah, you covered like every street.
We thought it was going to take about an hour. Took us about 3 hours to do. So, but yeah, then the newspaper ended up showing up, and that was a shock to me. You know, we weren't expecting that, so we were kind of just winging it. And I was updating. I had created, so both for the homemade Easter egg hunt and the fire truck with the bunny, I created events, so that way people could, I love events, because then they can say that they're going, and then they get updates on what's going on. And I had always said from day one, I will keep updating that event, so you know where the fire truck is at that time, because we did get behind schedule, but I was able to keep up on everyone's messages and just respond to people. And everyone was saying thank you for the updates, because I mean, we almost needed a tracker. Like I needed to put a tracker on us so people could follow us, but we didn't have
bunny
that.
Tracker.
So instead I was reaching out to them.
Bunny tracker.
Yeah, just, yeah, bunny tracker. Trying to stay ahead of everyone.
It was an odd day in Iowa though, because we had a little bit of rain with a little bit of snow and a little bit of ice, but the bunny rides on.
Yeah. So. Yeah. The bunny, we have video of the bunny riding with ice pellets coming down, like hail. It was just an Easter like no other. But another thing that we did was we created one meeting spot, which was a local park. And we said, we'll be there at 3:45 to 4 o'clock. And that way, if you missed us anytime throughout the route, you have your opportunity to come to that park and meet us
there.
Oh,
that's good. Yeah.
So I thought that'll help prevent anyone from missing us, that, you know, they have that opportunity to meet us at the park still.
That is phenomenal. Yeah. You just combined like children's two favorite things, like the Easter bunny and fire trucks. Like,
in right.
The ultimate Easter.
And even the adults, we had comments saying, you know, that thank you had put a smile on, you know, our face as the adults. They were happy and excited. Just, it makes you smile. Yeah.
Yeah, it is pretty cool. I mean, it takes Easter next level all of a sudden, you know what I mean?
Right.
You kind of think that's better than most Easters, you know, despite the conditions.
Yes. Right. Yeah, a lot of people are saying, like, I would take this Easter over anyone.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. No, and then you didn't stop there. Like, you guys have also really been trying to support, like, the medical community, too, since they're the ones on the front lines fighting the virus. So you guys started.
Yeah, we have.
Like, I know you did the doctor day. Tell me about that.
Yep. For about the past year, we've really been trying to reach out. Maybe it's even been 2 years now. Reach out and celebrate the National Doctor Day, National Teacher Day, National Librarian Day, you know, National Dentist Day. So then we'll go and we'll visit these businesses and we'll give them a special treat. Usually it's been like a fruit tray. And we just put a little ad on there that says, you know, Happy National Dentist Day from your More team. That's our Mark Olson real estate team.
Yeah.
And so it just happened to be National Doctor Day a few weeks ago. And so I'd reached out to a lady that worked there and she said, you know, it'd probably be best, which we were guessing, but we wanted to hear it from her, that, you know, we didn't bring in treats at this time. And so then some kids around the community have been doing chalk. And so I'm like, oh, well, how about if we go ahead and we put chalk down and we write encouraging messages. And so she approved that. So I went there with a group of kids, just got a few kids involved. And we went to the parking lot and the sidewalk, like where the doctors enter into their door. And we just wrote, you know, Happy National Doctors Day. We're proud of you. We appreciate you. You know, we appreciate the whole medical field because we like to include everybody. And we got a lot of positive feedback and people saying, you know, it just made them smile that we did that. And so that was one thing that we did that I think they really appreciated. Well, from that, then we built a relationship with the lady that I was coordinating with. And she happens to be like the COVID supervisor director right now. And so then she's been reaching out to us and I had said, let us know if there's anything we can do to help. And so she came up with asking us, she said that they were in need of elastic bands to make masks and wondering if we could help get that word out. And so we did. We created a post on our Facebook page and we asked for donations. And
it was amazing how fast those donations came in though. I mean, we had a couple people within 5 minutes of posting that and we had stuff delivered to the office that we were picking up.
Yeah, they grabbed seven, like anything that people could grab, you just grabbed it all. Yes, there's people that really came through and all within that weekend, she texted me back and said that they were able to sew enough masks to support two different establishments in our community that all the employees could get masks. So she was really excited about that. So since then, now she came back and she asked us for more elastic bands, but also isolation gowns and face shields is what she's looking for now too. So I really feel like, you know, I love helping people and I really feel like that's what, you know, we're able to do right now. I love that she's reaching out to us now and asking us if we want to help. Just today, she actually messaged and they are going to do, they're doing like the heart hunters around the nation. People can put up little hearts, just another way to make people smile. And so she said that they're gonna start doing that. And she asked if Remax would be a drop-off so people could make their heart and then drop it off at Remax. And so I just talked to her this morning about, yes, of course, we would love to do that for her.
That is amazing. Yeah,
so just keeping that relationship and getting to know the businesses.
And this is all in like 1 month. That's the thing. This is like in 30 days.
This is probably been the busiest 30 days. I just, yeah, the time's flown by.
Yeah, I thought when people say, is real estate slowing down? You're like, oh, no.
No. We've definitely
kept ourselves
occupied.
Yeah, we're putting our energy, you know, in other areas also, not just focusing on, of course, you know, real estate market and whatnot, but being able to reach out to the community is where we felt like we should focus our energy on right now.
Well, you guys,
and, I guess that kind of,
I'll tell you,
that kind of goes into the other week. I was thinking about, you know, I was on Facebook and some of our local Nevada, Iowa Facebook pages, and people are always asking, you know, is a certain store open? Is the restaurant delivering? What are their hours? Have they closed? And so I just felt like there was a big need to create a Facebook group where we could just house all this information in one place. Yeah. And I like to have things neatly organized, but I also like to be able to find the information right away. And so instead of having to search and ask, you know, on Facebook and try to wait for responses, then I went and created a Facebook group that is called Nevada, Iowa Business Updates. And that is a place where I can post, I kind of created a spreadsheet of the different businesses that are available or open still in Nevada. And then I included, you know, their hours, their location, their phone number, and directions and any special notes they need. And so that way people can just go straight to this Facebook page and they can find all this information in photos or albums that I place on there. And I'm also hoping that businesses will eventually, you know, and I've had a few that will share their business information onto that page. Otherwise, if I see them posting somewhere else about, like, you know, Dollar General is now open, they have new hours. And so then I'll comment under them and I'll say, hey, I started this new Facebook group. Do you mind sharing it here too? And I've had really great positive responses. So my goal would be that I can reach out to every business and kind of get one person that I can be in contact with, and that I can ask them about, you know, sharing information, and or let me know if there's any updates, and I can always do it for them. But again, just being the resource in the community to help everybody.
Yeah, and every aspect of the community, literally every aspect of the community. And I'll tell you, it's no profession is better situated to do that than real estate professionals. You know, because we, you know, we kind of are this referral connector throughout all of the community. We're the best dialed into social media. We're the best dialed in with email databases, with mailing databases. Like, we can get the word out and we can organize communities like no other industry can. So it's really on us to step up at times like this. Yeah. And I tell you, I don't know anybody doing it better than you guys. I mean, you guys are like you really set the standard for how real estate agents and brokers should behave going forward. So I think you're an amazing role model for the industry, and to be able to do all this is mind-boggling. It really is.
Thank you. I honestly, I don't feel like we could do it without, you know, you as a backbone. You saying, you know, giving, you know, sharing these ideas that you've heard from other realtors and whatnot. So
it takes a team. It takes a team to pull it off. Though we've got a great group of individuals that we work with, so there's not. It's not just the two of us. We bring an idea to the table and they run with it and help a lot. Sure. So it's been an awesome team.
That's
building
important.
Experience.
You do have a group of very dynamic people that are all very community centric too. So it's pretty phenomenal how you got that together and how everybody's getting behind it. So I'm just happy to be along for the ride. I mean, I just didn't expect you guys to jump on every single idea and then some.
Right.
Well, guys, thank you for so much your time and sharing all these ideas. I really do hope some of the other agents out there can use some of these and do more of the same out there like you guys have.
Yeah.
Well, thank you very much.
If anybody has any questions, reach out. We're an open book. Happy to help. So
awesome. Thanks, guys. And thank you guys for watching.
All right. Yeah. Okay. Thank you.